All right, basically, I'm a fucking hustler.
I'm a hustler.
He's a fucking hustler. Wait, start again, start again.
Go for it. Go for it.
Basically, I'm a fucking hustler, yeah?
Wait, start again, sorry. I was looking at that girl. All right. Oh, shit.
Oh, shut up, man. All right, so we're about to burgle this house. Obviously, most people do it from the back door, the back entrance, but we're gonna do it from the front entrance this time, yeah? Because it's, you know, it's not the obvious way to go about things, yeah? No one's expecting it, yeah?
Surprise.
If plan A don't work out, have a plan B, yeah? So enough halting, let's go in, let's do this.
Cool. Oh.
What do you tell the girls when they ask you what you do for a living?
Well, obviously, you know, you can't tell them straight up. You know, you can't tell them straight up you're a hustler. So obviously you've got to come up with like a little sort of alibi, as it were. Not an alibi, you know what I'm saying? But obviously I say like, you know, what do they want to hear? They want to hear that I'm a photographer. They want to hear that I'm a musician. You know, and I make beats. I spit bars, you know, I do all that stuff. But that's just the facade. Deep down, I'm just hustling hard every day, bruv. Every single day, hustling. That's what it is, that's what I do. But obviously, you've got to tell. Like, obviously, I'm born and bred in Brixton, bruv. But, you know, they've got the influx of hipsters nowadays. And that's a brilliant, like, disguise. So I use the hipster disguise. That's me, I use that.
That's smart, you know, that's kind of smart.
That's espionage 101, you know
what
I'm saying?
It's a bit like when you say you are a photographer, though, or a filmmaker. You just say you're a freelance, innit? So they can't get in too deep.
Freelance, exactly, exactly. And obviously I'm freelancing every single hustle that I do, bruv.
I was just born streetwise. That's how it was. I just, boom, popped straight out. Like, money on my brain. I want to go in hard for the money. I want to go in hard for the Queen's head. Do you know what I mean? My first words were like, why are you going to pay for that when I can be taking that for free?
Yeah, everything freelance. You've got to be free. You've got to be able to, like, swiftly move in and out of things. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Obviously, at the end of the day, I'm a hustler straight up. You can't say that to the girl. And obviously, the whole aspect of Brixton nowadays is just hipster, hipster, hipster.
Yeah, you look like a hipster a bit still.
Of course, yeah. It's espionage 101, you know what I'm saying? So, like, it's in disguise, you get me? It's like, you know, all these hipsters come in. That's the opportunity for me to blend in.
That's kind of smart.
I'm not going to roll down the street with tinted windows and grime playing out, you know what I'm saying? That's who's going to get fucking got by the feds, you know what I'm saying? They get locked up for time. I'm free. I've been free for 24 years.
This is the big monster. The door's unlocked. The guy who's an old friend of mine, actually, that's what I know about these things, but yeah, he always leaves the door open.
Right, that's kind of dumb though, still.
That's dumb, but that's where I come in. Take advantage of these mistakes. Because I can't run down the stairs with a HDTV.
Obviously not.
That'd be too obvious, that'd be too dumb. So, yeah, I mean, you get a lot of stick, a lot of flack for that, but that's what you need. Backbone, bottle, and of course, balls.
Yeah, there's bare bucks there.
These are shit.
Even like £1 a piece, there's like £1, £2, £3, £4, £5, £6, £7, £9, £10, £20, £40.
Here no, today? No, I can't sell that.
That shelf is £100.
So fair bounds?
Oh. £200 both shelves.
You know, furniture, mate. Speciality.
Oh yeah, fuck it. Move off, let's go.
Just leave it.
Straight on it, because as soon as you move your gear, then the sooner you are, no just break free. Like, there's no chance for you to get caught.
Even if she doesn't want it, I mean, just follow her, just insist. Half price.
She'll tell her friends as well. She'll say, I saw a good deal for Hoover, just down the block.
Obviously, she didn't buy it today, but like that doesn't mean, you know, it's not the end.
Don't give up. That's the first rule of marketing. Sell it.
Marketing, yeah.
This is the heart of the new Brixton, which is for hipsters.
Hipster central.
You know what hipster means? Hipster means money, fam.
Disposable income. And they like spending it.
Daddy's wallet.
On
daddy's
shit like this, yeah. So
that's what you need, student housing.
Yeah, man.
They don't provide this shit.
Extortionate prices, they don't know the difference, so.
Now we've got amp up the vibes.
And this is the heart of this group.
It's a great, it's in a bad move.
Some lads.
Yeah. These guys started off like what we were doing, and then they got all their shit together.
Got somewhere. Right? See what I mean? You can sell anything. Look at that. Selling wooden spoons.
Exactly.
Put our faces out there.
It's about image. It's about progress, man.
Alright, cheers, bud.
So, how do you make money in the ends?
Bikes. Once again. That's how we make the money, boys.
But do you buy them shit and sell them on?
I buy them shit and I sell them shit. And I charge a rip-off. That's how we do it, mate. That's how we do it.
How many bikes you got in the shed?
About 10. Yeah. About £4,000 worth.
Alright.
To hipsters. About £1,000 worth to myself.
Fred Perry t-shirts on eBay as well,
Fred
do, innit?
Fred Perry. I haven't been doing the Fred Perry for a while. Got a message from eBay, specifically from Fred Perry actually, through eBay saying, take these down or we'll fuck you up the arse, basically. So I chose not to be fucked up the arse, as you can imagine. And yeah, no Fred Perry's for a while.
It's like everyone's doing.
Yeah. So, what's your name?
Younger Imran.
What are you up to? How's life? How do you make money?
Well, right now I'm just at the bars, isn't it? Just training.
What hobbies do you have then, or something?
Fuck hobbies, man.
What? Ain't you into music, though?
Oh yeah. Always into my music, man. Beats, isn't it?
So obviously, Southeast London, you want to make a lot of money, but you want to do it by spending as little money as possible, yeah? And here, there's a lot of competition, a lot of competitors. This is one of our boys here, all right?
Yeah.
Yes, man. What are you saying?
Cool.
Yeah. So what are you up to?
I'm just out here selling my cupcakes. I bought them for £13.99.
Yeah.
And I'm making much more profit than many people. People don't even know. I sell each of them for £3. So I'm making £36 back.
That's it.
And recently I just go to Tesco as well and I buy cupcakes for £6. So
decent,
I sell them for £2 each as well. So I make back £24 from there. That's a lot of profit. That's £18.
Do people want to buy them? Straightforward?
Some people want to buy them. Some people say no. So I just ask for donations. I'll give you some donations.
Yeah, yeah.
But the thing is, you have to have a goal. If you don't have a goal, they won't give. If you don't have a plan, they won't give you nothing.
Yeah, exactly.
They'll just close the door on you. So,
how much money have you made so far?
I don't know. I can't count, but a lot.
Because they say they run South London.
They run in South London, yeah.
Stay fresh.
Prospects, really. The prospect of finding that big, you know, gold mine. Because obviously, when you're out here, it's always you're sifting through the shit looking for the gold. I mean, you could be sifting through for like years if you're unlucky. But if you're lucky, it could be like 2 days. Within 2 days, bang,
you
found the gold mine.
Still, man, can you?
No, that's true. And obviously, if you're not out there playing the game, you're not going to be able to win, are you?
Yeah.
So, it's the prospect that keeps me going, the prospect of, you know, winning the lottery, sort of. Not obviously not winning the lottery, because that's very unlikely, but...
But similar to winning the lottery, you've got to roll the dice, man. You've got to...
Exactly. I mean, if you're going to rob, like, just say a man on the street, he could have, like, 20p in his pocket, or he could have, you know, 40 quid.
Yeah. Pissed off. I'm always pissed off these days. A lot of people are getting on my back on my Twitter, saying I'm not a real hustler, saying I'm a poser. Wait for it. Today, final straw, they said, Detroit, you're nothing but a fucking standard hipster. I was like, it gets to me. It gets to me. I'm struggling, boys. I'm struggling. I'm on edge. What's happened? Do I look like a hipster? Just because I wear these fucking clothes. Is it my fault that a 29-year-old comes down to Brixton and wears the same gear as me? What can I do? And I take the fleck. I don't follow trends, I set them. Some boys, if you're going to tweet me, tweet me. If you're going to come out here, come out here. If you're going to call me out. You know where I am. I'm always in surf. It's my bread and butter.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
It's chirps in yesterday.
You stole her from
She's
me.
She's alright still.
You stole her.
The best man won, obviously.
She was mine though.
But always happens, isn't it? But yeah, apparently she's got like quite a expensive guitar at her house. And she's invited me round, so.
Yeah. I mean, this area speaks for itself. Look at all this.
Look at all this. This is some well off area right now.
This just means money to me, like.
Obviously, if she's got everything she needs, then why not?
Okay.
You know, why not take her off?
So what, you're going to bring her upstairs?
So I'm gonna be shagging her, right? That's the distraction. You're gonna go in,
yeah.
Find the guitar, find everything else that's worth
it. Okay. So just do my natural thing, yeah?
Obviously, yeah. Give me like 10 minutes, 5 minutes.
Just give me time. I need time.
Bro, I can't last like.
She probably locks that to secret safe.
I can't last that long though. I think like you got like 5 minutes max, 10 minutes.
All right, just let me do what I do, yeah.
Yeah. Once I bust, man. You ain't got a lot of time. Trust me.
All right.
So anyway, where's the house?
All right, let's get pumped up for this now, man. Watch and learn, kids. Yeah, that's how you do it.
Yeah.
Let's go.
All
right,
sit.
Just wait here. Just wait. Okay, this is when you know you've hit the jackpot, yeah? When it's just art, left, right, and center, 360. That's how you know. When people spend money on art, that's what, how you know they got money to just burn. It's fine in the kitchen, like. No. Come on, guitar. Alright, you know what? Let's have a little look out there. Keep an eye on Henry, yeah? Is it really stupid or is it really smart?
Well, I think it's stupid, and I actually question whether anybody will actually take you up on that.
Yes.
Let's see if that happens.
So, should he get in or should he get out of this whole lifestyle?
Me. Have you actually gotten into that lifestyle though?
Hmm.
So, what do you think about Henry?
He's just
nothing.
Just idiots. One word. Arseholes.
So obviously just in Peckham looking for some opportunities. I'm gonna fuck Peckham over, bruv. Rookie all day, innit? There's a
Let's
nice car
this.
Here still.
Let's just
there's a
do
nice
this,
car. They're just waiting there, bruv, to get jacked, innit? So obviously hood up. I don't have a hood actually, fuck.
Let's do this, man.
Out now.
Hey, drive. Hey, brother, I don't have to drive actually. I don't have to fucking drive. Get out.
This hustle game. Why do you do it?
Why? Mate, there's a lot of reasons. Reason number one, money. Money is what makes the world go around. If you don't have money, you can't buy Nike trainers, you know what I'm saying? Reason number two, image. It sort of ties in with buying Nike trainers and stuff. But if people know that you're a hustler, then obviously respect is what you'll get. You know what I'm saying? Reason number three, why do I do this? Boredom, really, you know, what is there for kids to do nowadays, isn't it? They don't have, like, play centres for us to play in, you know what I'm saying? So, what is there that we need to do? Obviously, if you don't have community centres where, you know, with, like, slides and stuff, what is there to do other than hustle, you know what I'm saying? So, that's reason number three. Now, number four, reason number four, shit, why do I do this? I have to be honest, like, what? Why do you do anything? Like, why do you go to the post office? If you're a postman, why do you be a postman? It's like, you know what I'm saying? To deliver the post.
That's it.
Come on in. This is where the magic happens. This is where the bikes get sold.
Fucking hell. There's a lot of gear, a lot of bikes in this shed.
There's a lot of gear in here indeed. A lot of money to be made. I need to start selling more, you know?
Yeah. So who's this little lady down here?
What, this lady? Oh, this is, ladies and gentlemen, Judith! 6 kilos, Shimano Altegra. She's been with me for about, 4 years? And yeah, should we do the old little pinky test just to impress all those people watching? Oh. What? No, let's try the index. I think that's a bit more reasonable, you know. One, two, three. Woo! Yeah, she's still got it.
Yeah, sweet as. That's a nice bike, but you know what? If I was you, I don't think I could sell that, you know what I mean?
No, that's not being sold. That's strictly used for training purposes only.
Fair play.
But yeah, everything else you see in here, you want to buy it, talk to me, you know.
You're not going to sell this piece of shit down here, are you?
This piece of shit, as you so eloquently put it, is made by the Tomasini family in Italy. Worth to the average hipster, 1,500 quid, and it's going to make me a mint, so the joke's on you, pal.
So what, are you a professional or something?
Am I a professional? I'll let you be the judge of that when I tell you that Brixton Cycles offered me a contract for sponsorship, and Evans have overcut them, and I'm just sitting back here like Alan Sugar, letting them fight. I don't really give a shit either way, you know, it's gonna happen, so. Money's money, innit? Whatever.
Fuck it, man, let's just talk business now.
Business! That's what I like to hear! Let's talk business.
Business, who's your biggest customer?
My biggest customer? Oh, put me on the spot right there, ain't ya? Woo! Biggest customer, yeah. I fucking know. Queen Elizabeth, Your Majesty. Mwah.
My name's
name's Louis Lloyd, and this is Brixton Market. Everyone's on edge. Everyone's got an image here, you know? And that's the trait to a perfect hustler.
Yeah.
Can't just be hustling left, right and centre, talking absolute nonsense. You've got to keep face about it. And that's what I'm doing here. I'm hustling right now. Put me to the test. Sometimes I feel as though I've been blessed because I'm doing what I want. So I never rest. So here we are in Hustle Bucks. We found the perfect shot for us. So do you have to do any hustling to get this shop up and underway? Does the word hustle come true?
Yeah, loads of hustling. Look at it, downtown, but when this
world was born, but when the snow is falling, then that I could be just walking down the street to the untrained eye. To the naked eye, I'm just a very good looking 24-year-old walking down the street looking for some fruit and veg. I'm hustling, mate. I'm always hustling.
Today we're going to go up to uptown Paddington, get out of the ends for a little bit, see what opportunities arise.
And you open the door and you step inside. We're inside our hearts. Now imagine your pain is a white wall of healing light. That's right, your pain, the pain itself, is a white wall of healing light.
It's local. Change here. The National Rail Services.
They're probably lost anyway.
Hi children, does anyone need a tour guide? A tour guide at Paddington Station.
Walking tour. Roads.
Shank tea, obviously.
Yeah.
Smell that, it's going to be a good day today. If you smell that buzz, that
sorry.
Light.
Sorry.
What end do you from?
What ends?
What specific? What postcode? NW3. Alright. What? Right. What
do you do to make
money in the ends?
Film stuff.
Film stuff like us?
Big.
Yeah. What do you film?
Tennis clubs, bars, restaurants, that sort of thing. Websites, yeah.
Okay. Are you a member of a golf club?
I'm not.
No.
Member of a tennis club.
Oh, how much do you make a year?
20 grand.
Told you.
How old I need to be able to be around to talk to you.
Are you a rent boy?
Sorry?
Are you a rent boy?
Rent boy.
Fucking hell. This guy's desperate for money. It's a white ball of healing light. I don't think so.
The multinational corporations like the Body Shop deserve to be hit hard, bruv. So man's just gonna check a little something, try and show it on around here.
Still from a corporate fucking exactly. Assholes, like.
Fuck that, man. Fuck George Bush and everything.
Right, I'll wait out here, like.
Probably
killed a monkey for that.
Probably, yeah. Probably tested it all on like the parrots and shit.
this shower gel.
Yeah, yeah.
So obviously you clean yourself with that.
Sin.
Brother, and it's green as well. That's a friendly colour, so yeah. That'll be easy to sell on.
It's about the environment. Recycle that, innit? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we'll try to sell it on.
Maybe you can sell it now, like.
Do you want to let my body shop, brand new, for your wife or sister? I mean, like, daughter. Or for your daughter, innit? Yeah, because she looks young, innit?
Why did you buy it? No, you want to sell it?
It was a gift. For you, £15.
Only £15.
For you, £10. For you, £8.99.
Say no more.
We'll tell your friends. See you later.
Cheers, cheers.
Oh, wait, what about these girls?
So no.
The next station is Bayswater.
With bringing in strangers off the street, what if it's a rat?
Obviously you've got to show them what you'll do to rats. So in the past I've photoshopped pictures of me like proper fucking people up, like torturing people, and obviously they don't know it's photoshopped because they're probably like, you know, they don't know. But I show them those pictures, I say, if you're horrible, if you're a snitch, then this is what's gonna happen. This is what happened to Larry the snitch, you know, 2 weeks ago, and now he's in hospital and he can't speak because I cut his tongue out. So obviously they don't know that I'm chatting shit, but it's all about the image, you know, like North Korea and shit.
Hi, younger Imran's a bad still.
I've learnt a lot this summer.
About myself, about, like, you know, life.
It's been a busy summer.
Yeah, a lot has happened.
Come on, man!
Anger.
You know, frustration.
Envy.
Happiness.
Magic.
You know, sadness.
Lust.
Love, you know.
Temptation.
Lust.
It's all the trademarks of a good hustle.
Yeah. But hustling, you can't always measure hustling. Say, like, you made this amount of money.
Yeah.
You may have made this amount of money, but you've probably learned that much, and that's more valuable.
And that's how it, you can't see it. It's like that.
Yeah.
What is hustle? You can't explain it.
Exactly.
It's like culture. It's different to every single person.
What is life, you know?
Life is hustle, hustle is life. That's exactly what you're doing. As soon as you pop out there, you're hustling.
To be honest, you know, right now I'm happy. I mean, the snow's gonna fall, you know, the leaves are gonna fall, the snow's coming.
It's not all gonna go perfect. And that's what you learn. There's lots of hiccups along the way, lots of obstacles. But you power through, and you fucking hustle again.
Safe, bro.
It's cool, say nothing, bro.
Oh, nice one.